here at the Wyke Thames Performing Arts Center, and I'm so excited to welcome you to today's performance of Footloose. I'm actually a former camper and intern here, and I'm so excited to be working again this summer as an apprentice. It has been such a pleasure to work with all of these talented young performers. They are all so wonderful and fun, and they've been working so hard to put together this incredible production that you are about to see in just 3 weeks. Very impressive. Just a few housekeeping things before we start. Please turn off all of your cell phones. There are also no photos and videos during this production, and both can be available to purchase. Also, please come out and see our main stage season starting in October. We are putting on The Prom, Jersey Boys, and Miss Saigon, and subscriptions are available to buy. We are a nonprofit theater, so we hope you will please continue to come out and support live theater in your community. On that note, we hope you enjoy the show and get ready to cut loose.
Everybody cut. On my way to church this morning, I heard our choir warming up in the distance, and I was reminded of a line from our great poet, Walt Whitman, who wrote, "I hear America singing." And I thought, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we lift our voices to tell the world who we are and what we believe? So this morning I ask you, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. But we were barely hanging on there, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we could stay. But maybe Mom can find a job that's steady, and maybe I can stand it for a year.
And maybe things won't be so bad.
And maybe I won't miss my daddy. Maybe we can start a new life here.
Start a new life here.
America singing. All I hear is rock and roll music preaching a gospel of relaxed morals. And I ask myself, why? Why does our Lord allow this? We know God has the power to turn all these records and books and videos into one big fiery cinder like that. But he doesn't. And why? Because God is testing us. And so every day we must ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
The right thing, the right thing. We try to do what's right. The right thing, the right thing. Sin is a matter of black and white.
This morning I welcome two new souls just arrived from Chicago, Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, is it?
It's Ren.
Huh? Speak up! Let the Lord hear your voice!
Ren! Ren McCormick.
Ren McCormick.
Ren! Interesting name. Is that short for something?
Nope.
There's rumors going round about the new kid, and everybody's talking till they're blue. Cause you know how a stranger is. If he's not dumb, he's dangerous. But either way,
Joe, isn't he cute?
Uh-huh.
Catch you later.
here.
See ya. And where are you going?
Where do you think?
Ooh!
And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all evening, right?
Asking us to lie for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, mister, you bumped me. Sorry. Listen, fella, around here you push somebody, they push back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Got it. Let me ask you something. They sell men's clothes where you get that hat?
What is that? Some kind of stupid joke?
No, actually, it's a really good joke.
That's it, man. I'm gonna kill you.
No! Kill me! That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I hit this town. Ren McCormick, and you are?
Willard Hewitt.
Willard, what do you do around here for your time? Got any clubs?
Nope.
What about movies?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
Oh, what about?
Nope. We do have the Bowlerama down by the interstate.
Wow, I really admire you. I can never do what you guys do around here.
Well, what do we do?
Nothing!
Don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should kick back and chill, but I can't sit still.
I can see that.
Call the doctor, he said, son, I cannot offer you a pill. So I never found relief, and now I've got to move until I've had my fill. I can't stand still.
Around here we walk.
Back where I come from, I shiver, oh no, I wish I could be there. Oh, we had the world at our feet, life is sweet, ain't no doubt, grab a seat, check it out.
Dancing. You got it. He convinced the town council it was all a sin, and just
Wait, Reverend Moore has this kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power.
He is the law.
Man, how could you stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of it.
I thought living in a small town was gonna be just perfect. Like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. Careful what you do, someone's on to you. Careful what you do. Careful what you say, cause you're on display every night and every day. Somebody's hiding in the great unknown. And every time you think that you're alone, ha! Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go. Somebody's out there waiting for the show. You've got no disguise from somebody's eyes.
Thanks for the advice, but it's not gonna get to me.
It gets to everyone.
You don't know me.
You don't know Beaumont.
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa!
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa!
You're gonna have to learn that in Beaumont, a stop sign means that you stop.
I thought I did, officer.
And that radio music of yours was blasting pretty loudly.
Oh, so you pulled me over because my music's too loud?
Watch that attitude, son!
Careful how you speak, turn the other cheek. Be careful how you speak. Think a naughty thought, and if you get caught, well then boy, you bought a lot of
crazy about my seeing you.
Well, I'm gonna tell him to get used to it.
Maybe not right now.
not in the mood for one of his sermons.
Hey, tomorrow, my place at 6, right?
Yes, now go. Go home. Wendy Jo, did you guys order yet?
Not yet.
Ariel, your book report is great.
I almost wish I read the book. How do you pronounce this word?
Camelot?
Ooh, I like the part where King Arthur and Lancelot fight over Guinevere. It's right after Mordred says, I'm the king, I'm the king.
You read a book?
Cliff Notes. It took me forever.
Ooh, in the book, there's all these knights on horseback jousting and storming the castle.
All we get are guys in overalls riding pickup trucks.
Hey, Rusty.
Hey, Willard.
Well, see ya.
When are you two gonna have a real conversation?
Oh, Willard is not capable of having a real conversation. I kind of like that in a guy.
Hey, Ren, how's the new job?
Well, it's my second day waiting tables and I've not been fired yet.
Oof, you may have found the future.
Maybe. What can I get you guys to eat?
Diet Coke.
Diet Coke.
I'll have the Hula Burger double patty cheese melt with extra mayo and a side of fries. And a Diet Coke.
Okay, and Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Ariel!
You know, Mama says when a girl looks at you like I've seen Ariel looking, she is on you like a hog on slop.
Get out of here.
But if Chuck sees you flirting with Ariel, you are a dead man.
Oh, come on! I was only teasing him.
That is more than teasing.
You know, Fred's cute, but can you really compete with Chuck Cranston, the rugged high school dropout? I don't think so.
If only I could find a guy who'd make the first move. If only I could find a guy that, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
If only I could find a guy.
Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods?
Yeah.
Where's the streetwise Hercules?
I'm holding out for a hero.
had a date half an hour ago.
Chuck, I'm sorry.
Hey, 6 o'clock. What am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down. Don't ever tell me what to do. Now, let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I believe the lady said no.
Ariel, who invited this clown?
Oh, I'm sorry. We haven't been formally introduced yet. Ren McCormick.
Put your hand on my face. Get your face out of my sight.
Hey, Chuck.
Looking for a fight? Let's fly.
Ha, ha, ha! Ha, ha, hoo, ha! Ha, ha!
We got a problem here?
Oh, not at all, ma'am. We were just discussing the safety and comfort of one of your valued customers.
What, you think that's funny?
Mr. Cranston, this here is my establishment, and your truck is parked on my sidewalk. You've got about 30 seconds till I have it towed, so I suggest you move along.
This isn't the last you've seen of me, McCormick.
Could I please kick his butt?
Willard, what's that your mama says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fight. Well, this is not your fight. Now, don't we all have curfew? You're either very brave or very stupid.
And which do you think?
I haven't made up my mind.
Come on, I'll walk you home.
Good night, Ren. Why your daddy left in the first place.
Count to 10, man. Mama says just count to 10.
It'd be wise to take your friend's advice. Now get down and give me 30.
You're joking.
You're right. Make it 50.
He's not faking it, Coach. He's really hurting.
Thank you for the diagnosis, Dr. Ward. You can give me 50 as well. As a matter of fact, you can all give me 50. Oh, just do it. One, two, I can't hear you,
three,
four, only 46 more.
Six. Caesar? Yeah. Thanks a lot.
I'm sorry, it's just that this town, it's so wound up. You guys have no place to blow off any steam. At least in Chicago, we could go back to our clubs.
Hey, maybe we ought to take the coach dancing.
You are so...
What's going on, Red? What are you thinking?
That's it. We are going to throw a dance. We are going to throw an awesome party that knocks Beaumont right off its tractor.
Are you ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I'll take on anybody.
But what about the town council?
I'll fight City Hall.
But Beaumont will never let us forget the Batani Bridge accident.
How long do you have to live in that shadow? There's got to be a way out of this.
The only way out of this is by train.
No. Listen.
Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. If there's anything worth the fear, it's worth the fight. No one can tie my hands or make me change my plans. I'm crossing the line, jumping the track, taking what's mine and not looking back. Heaven helps a man who fights his fear. Every day I face a new frontier. I can't worry what the world will say. I may fly or fall, but either way, I'm free. Come on, try it.
I'm free.
Is that all you've got?
I'm free.
That's more like it.
I'm taking the past, making our trace, taking control, if that's what it takes. Heaven helps a man who fights it.
Dancing. This law is a tribute to four young people who held the promise of Beaumont's brightest futures.
Heaven helps a man.
And we stand united in honoring their memory.
We can face this down.
Heaven help me
so handsome tonight.
You're just saying that.
The problem is,
yeah,
between you and me,
uh-huh,
I can't do this. I can't dance!
What?
None.
Didn't he never take you in his arms and sweep you off your feet?
No, but that's not how it is with Dean Willard. No, really. Willard has a lot of hidden talents. I mean, just look at him.
Answering for herself.
I don't know what good that would do.
Mama says it doesn't matter if you love around town.
Once you travel the mountain, you can't back down. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down.
Don't make me say it again.
Yeah. next meeting of the town council, I want to remind our young people that disturbances will not be tolerated. The floor is now open.
My name is Ren McCormick, and on behalf of most of the senior class of Beaumont High, I move that local ordinance 416, the law against public dancing within the town limits of Beaumont, be abolished.
And I will urge you to second that motion.
It is my duty to challenge any enterprise which fosters spiritual corruption. Now, if anyone can convince me that there's no danger in your raucous party plans, I might reconsider my stand. But for now, no, I can't condone it.
Excuse me, Reverend, but aren't we told in Psalm 149 to praise ye the Lord? Sing unto the Lord a new song. Praise the Lord's name in the dance. And it was King David, who we read about in Samuel. And what did David do? What did David do? David danced before the Lord with all his might, leaping and dancing with all his might, leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes assures us that there is a time for every purpose under heaven. There's a time to laugh, and there's a time to weep. There's a time to mourn, and there's a time to dance. Yeah! There's a time for this law, but not anymore. Not anymore. Thank you.
Order, order. There is a motion on the floor to repeal local ordinance 416. How does the town council vote?
No. No.
No.
No. The motion is defeated. This meeting is adjourned.
Reverend Moore had those votes locked up way before you walked in here tonight.
You think he told the town council how to vote?
You can still sound shocked. I love that about you.
He's a man of God.
He's a man, and you were railroaded. But if you can convince Reverend Moore that there's no danger in your raucous party planning, then he'll reconsider. Make him reconsider.
But
until you do, you'll never make peace with this man or this town. Now go.
Question. For tonight's meeting, did you tell the town council how to vote?
We discussed the issue, of course.
But did you tell them how to vote?
Ren, this is more than the issue of a dance.
Did you? Reverend Moore, I understand what this town has been through.
If you did, you wouldn't have provoked your classmates to reopen wounds we have healed.
Those wounds are not healed. If they were, you wouldn't be fixing the vote on the town council.
I had to put an end to this nonsense!
Nonsense? All I say is, who's up for a little dancing? And the only thing people can think about in this town is the Petone Bridge and the forehead.
Mr. McCormick!
And I know your son was one of them, and I'm sorry for your loss. I truly am. But honoring their memory by shutting out the world is not working.
How can you presume to know what I've been through? You have no clue. Good night, Mr. McCormick. I would like to be alone.
Sir, you already are! We both are. We've both lost somebody. I bet you stop 100 times a day and wonder why. I do. I wonder, why'd my dad have to leave? Could I have made him stay? Maybe, just maybe, I could bring him back, but I can't. I don't need to tell you what that feels like. You know what that's like.
Yeah, I do.
So, I guess I came to this town frustrated and angry. And it felt really good to kick up the fuss. And I know it got people upset, and I'm sorry for that. But I'm just trying to move on, because I'm so tired of looking back. And look, I know you're going to do what you've got to do about the dance and all, but thanks for listening.
Ren, I'm sorry that your father won't ever get to know you.
Thank you.
I thought I heard voices.
That was your friend, Ren. He sure asks a lot of questions.
And what did you tell him?
Well, for a change, I had very little to say. I think I'm running out of answers.
Daddy, I know that this is hard for you. And I know that I don't make it any easier. I just don't know. I believe in all the things that you believe in, but I believe.
a sermon in the morning.
If I can figure out what to say.
You will.
This morning I come to you with a troubled heart. As your minister, I should be helping you to find the joy in your lives. Last night, I realized that I haven't been doing that. On a terrible night 5 years ago, everybody in this community lost a loved one on the Petani Bridge. A child, a friend, a neighbor. I, Violet, and I, we lost our son. Ariel lost her brother. I somehow got it into my head that my loss was the greatest, that my pain was the deepest. And then someone helped me realize how tightly I've been holding on to that memory. And in that moment, I did something I haven't done in a very long time. I laid down my burden. It was a terrifying moment, and it was exhilarating. This morning, I offer you the same opportunity. The senior class of Beaumont High School has asked permission to hold a dance. Ren, I think that might be a good idea. Please join me in asking our Lord to guide and protect our children.
Flowers,
12 bucks,
and on my 20-year truck, I finally tied my tie.